Former Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile is set to make his political comeback as the presidential legal counsel of incoming President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., the son and namesake of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos, whom Enrile served for years as Justice Secretary and as Defense Minister. Marcos's camp earlier announced that Enrile has accepted the post, saying that he would devote his time and knowledge for the Republic and for Marcos Jr. to succeed as Philippine President. Enrile is known to be the architect and implementer of Marcos Sr.'s martial law, which saw thousands of human rights violations against activists and critics of the government in the 70s and the 80s. It was his alleged ambush in 1972 that triggered the declaration of martial law in the Philippines. Enrile withdrew his support for the dictator back then and supported the EDSA People Power Movement, which ousted the Marcos family from power in 1986. The 98-year-old politician is also known as one of the longest-serving senators of the Republic. He also became Senate President and is remembered for presiding over the impeachment trial of late Chief Justice Renato Corona. Meanwhile, incumbent Justice Secretary Minardo Guevara has been chosen to be the next administration's Solicitor General. Incoming Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles says Guevara was chosen for his sterling performance as a lawyer for over 30 years. Guevara graduated magna cum laude from the Ateneo de Manila University's Political Science Program and earned his Master's in Economics title from the University of the Philippines. He returned to the Ateneo to study law and got the second highest score in the 1985 bar examinations. Guevara says 10 years ago, he was asked to pick between being named Justice Secretary and Solicitor General, but noted that that time he wasn't ripe back then. Now, faced with the same choices, Guevara picked the office of the Solicitor General over the current agency he is heading, saying the position suits him better due to his nearly three-decade law practice. The National Union of People's Lawyers noted that while it did not agree with Guevara on several issues, they see the incoming Solicitor General as a decent, reasonable, and well-respected public official who is faithful to the rule of law and due process. NUPL President Edre Olalia says he hopes Guevara will serve as the Marcos cabinet's conscience when it comes to matters of human rights and good governance. He adds the NUPL is hopeful that Guevara can regain the trust, professionalism, and integrity that were allegedly compromised due to politicking and the weaponization of the law. As for the Department of National Defense, retired Armed Forces of the Philippines Chief of Staff Jose Faustino Jr. will first serve as Undersecretary of the agency until November 12, when he marks his first year as a retired general. On November 13, Marcos can officially nominate Faustino as Secretary of National Defense, because under the law, retired military officials may only be appointed to a cabinet position at least 1 year after their retirement. Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana welcomed Marcos's choice for his replacement, saying Faustino is dedicated to continue the gains of the agency on internal security, external defense, and modernization efforts. Faustino is an alumnus of the Philippine Military Academy's Maringal class of 1988. He served as an intelligence official and was a war veteran in Mindanao before he was appointed commanding general of the Philippine Army and eventually chief of staff of the AFP. The president-elect has yet to name his secretaries for several other important agencies, including the Departments of Health, Energy, and Agriculture. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.